5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। द रिकॉर्ड रिवील्ड दैट द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट वॉज सीज्ड विद द इशू एज टू वेदर आफ्टर द ऑर्डर ऑफ द हियरिंग अथॉरिटी डेटेड 25 अप्रैल 2008 पब्लिकेशन ऑफ द मॉडिफाइड स्कीम वॉज रिक्वायर्ड एज पर लॉ आर नॉट बट नो फाइनल डिसीजन कुड बी टेकन इन दिस रिगार्ड एंड अल्टीमेटली एज पर द नोट सीट डेटेड 31 मई 2013 द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट प्रपोज्ड टू कैंसल विथड्रॉ द प्रपोजल फॉर मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ द स्कीम डेटेड 5 अगस्त 2005 बट नो फाइनल डिसीजन कुड बी टेकन इवन ऑन दिस इशू एंड द मैटर रिमेंड पेंडिंग अवेटिंग द ओपिनियन ऑफ द लीगल रिमेंबरेंस इन द मैटर In view of the above discussion, this court is of the view that in the absence of any decision of the state government approving the modified scheme dated 5 August 2005 as envisaged under section 102 of the Act 1988 as per the dictum in Rashid Javed case, the route in question continues to be a notified nationalized route in respect of which the state transport undertaking and the persons mentioned in the notified scheme are persons legally entitled to ply as successor in interest alone are entitled to ply. It being so, the rejection of the application of the opposite parties for grant of permit on the said route on the ground of it being a nationalized route did not suffer from any error and it would not be amenable to an appeal under section 89 of the Act 1988. It being so, the very basis for rejection of the application for impediment filed by the petitioner herein by the appellate authority to also denying him a right of hearing falls to the ground. The remedy, if any, was by way of a revision under section 90 of the Act 1988 and under the proviso to section 90, no order could be passed in such revision unless the person who would be prejudiced by such order are given a reasonable opportunity of being heard. Had the private opposite parties filed such a revision, the revisional court would have considered the question of locus standi in the light of the aforesaid proviso. Suffice it to say that a specific assertion has been made in the paragraph 4 of the writ petition that the applicants and their predecessors in interest were permitted to ply the vehicle on the route in question as per the scheme notified, which has not been specifically and categorically denied either by the private opposite party or by the state in their counter affidavit. In fact, it has been admitted in the counter affidavit that the petitioner is plying on the route in question. During the course of the argument, Sri Saxena himself stated that the petitioner was plying on the route in question in terms of some interim order passed by the revisional authority. Had it been a non-notified route, then the plea of the opposite parties as regards locals in the standi may have carried weight in view of the authorities cited by them, but it being a notified route, it cannot be said that he does not have any locus standi to maintain this petition.